Watauga Arts Council with your host, Cherry Johnson, serving arts in Watauga County for more than 30 years.
I'm Cherry Johnson with Watauga County Arts Council, and the Arts Council likes to partner. We believe strongly that if you try to do it all by yourself, you work four times as hard and you get half the results. Then if you team up with somebody and you work with them and you enable each other in your own way, each of you brings things to the table and you often get four times the results for half the effort, which is really kind of cool. And so I want to introduce you to Suzanne Thompson. Suzanne, you're with the Friends of the Library, is that correct?
That's correct.
And you came to me a while back with you were introduced by a mutual friend to me, and you have a cool project that you're working on, and we decided that the Arts Council had a role to play in this project.
You do indeed.
Okay, yeah. So let's describe your project first.
Okay. Well, as you know, the Friends of the Library support things for the library that the library is otherwise unable to do budget-wise.
Right.
Our biggest fundraiser that we do is the book sale that most people have been to at the mall.
Yes.
Which will be in May, by the way.
Everybody put that on your calendar.
May 17th, 18th, and 19th at the mall. This year we decided to kind of ratchet things up a little bit, not just for fundraising, but for books.
Mm-hmm.
So we are planning a book festival, the High Country Festival of the Book, which will be held August 3rd and 4th at the Meadowbrook Inn in Blowing Rock.
That's a totally unique concept for this community.
Yes.
I don't think I've ever seen in all the years I've been living and working here anything quite like this.
No, yeah. I think it's going to be. I'm really excited. And as things have happened, we're all getting really excited.
Yeah.
We are getting lots of authors to come. What we're going to do is it's going to be open, free to the public all day on Saturday.
Right.
We're going to have, in their ballroom, we're going to have exhibitors, which will be antiquarian book dealers, publishers like University of North Carolina, McFarland. We're also going to have some authors in there doing some book signings, and then we're going to have author panels all day where authors will be coming together to talk on specific subjects like the Civil War, mystery writers, and then we're going to have also in another meeting room, we're taking over the hotel, literally.
And they don't mind.
And they're very happy with that. We're taking over the hotel, and in another meeting room, we're going to have authors who are giving presentations.
Mm-hmm.
And then that evening, we're going to do a movable book feast, or a movable author feast, where the authors actually move from table to table.
Right.
And that will be our major fundraising aspect of this. That one
that's
you
great.
Need to get a ticket for.
But, that's great. Now, I know that this is way out there. It's in, what, August?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know the exact dates?
3rd, 4th.
August 3rd and 4th. So, therefore, you're not going to remember this all the time. None of us will. So, in order, the Arts Council has a role. Now, we already are involved in the literary arts in a lot of different ways. I bring a lot of authors on this particular show here to interview with and talk with you about. And we have them at the openings at the galleries and things like that. But we decided there was a different twist that we could take with this thing. As you know, the Arts Council already does a juried art competition. We're doing that in April. And it kind of inspired us to think about May. And we happened at that point in time to have the Open Door Gallery slot open for May. The Open Door Gallery is the gallery upstairs in the Jones House with the hardwood floor. And it's a fairly small room. It's not humongous, but it will have enough room to do this. What we're doing is inviting artists to participate in a poster competition. Now, we're not talking about little kitties with crayons. We're talking about real artwork that can be put on a poster, and then they will, with that art, create a really cool poster that will be put all over town so that you won't forget when the book festival is.
Well, and it's not a new concept. We kind of stole this from some other book festivals, the big one that they do in Washington, D.C.,
right.
The Savannah Book Festival. And what we would like, we've come up with a theme. The theme this year, because it's High Country Festival of the Book, is Mountain Stories.
Mm-hmm.
And that could be anything from folklore to like a Cherokee tale, or even say Charles Fraser's Cold Mountain. I mean, it's a big
so
range.
Just interpret,
but an interpretation, an artist's interpretation. What we're looking for something in color that can be used as poster art.
Right.
Sort of like those museum type things that you buy. So I think we want something, you know, really evocative mm-hmm. of that. And it will be used, as you said, for a poster that we would sell, for all of our banners, for our invitations to the movable feast right. dinner, all of the anything that we put out there. You know, if we do a coffee mug or a book bag, thank you notes even, you know, we're going to want to just really get that out there. And the other thing that we would like is to be able to take this original piece of artwork and auction it off at our movable feast. And the winner of this art is going to get 2 free tickets to the movable feast, which was $200.
We're talking about the artist that wins,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm. That's right. And I think, well, we'll put it on our website.
And all that publicity and all that notoriety.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
You know, their name will be down at the bottom, and we mm-hmm. would ask them to sign some of the posters and,
right.
and be there at the book festival.
So you can get famous quick.
Oh, I would think so. Yeah. What a great opportunity.
It really is. The Blue Ridge Wine and Food Festival has been doing this sort of a concept similar to this for many years. And I have watched some of our local artists do some incredible work, which has become memorialized, and people collect those posters. So I have a feeling we're starting a trend here. You know, we're going to mm-hmm. start collecting these posters with this our original artwork that inspires these, that's put onto these posters.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this
yeah.
will be something that will be a very special poster. It just won't be just your average, a few words on a page. You know,
mm-mm.
it'll
no.
be really something
no,
neat.
No, it will. And it'll be, I think it'll be frameable artwork mm-hmm. that yes, exactly. And for years to come, hopefully, the book festival will be working with you guys and have
that's
something
right.
different every year.
Now, I mentioned the Open Door Gallery. During the month of May, our gallery exhibit will be all the entries into this competition.
Right.
The competition will be juried by the Arts Council's own gallery committee, which is a group of several folks in the community who work very hard to keep the galleries supplied with wonderful artwork. And so they already know what great artwork looks like, and they'll do a wonderful job to select one. So and we will have a reception, and you had the date here, May the
4th? I do, it's May the 4th.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And so there'll be a reception at which you'll be able to come and maybe meet the artists that have their work participating in this particular competition. And we'll announce the winner and really get it, you know, make a big deal about who that person is. We might even bring them back and let you meet them on this show.
Mm-hmm.
But I want you to spread the word to all the artists in the community. We will be putting the specifics of this competition on both the websites.
Correct.
The Arts Council's website is watauga-arts.org, and your website is
the High Country Festival of the Book.com.
Easy. Yeah.
And actually, I already have it on my website.
Wonderful.
And I would encourage you all to look at the website, because we are adding new authors every
mm-hmm.
day. And may I
mm-hmm.
just
sure.
give a little preview of some of the... we've got Fred Chappell coming.
Uh-huh.
We have Rita Mae Brown. We have Robert Morgan. And we've got some more locally known authors
mm-hmm.
like Julia Taylor Ebel is going
mm-hmm.
to be there. So we're so excited about this.
This is going to be a wonderful event. Absolutely wonderful, and we're really looking forward to our role in helping it happen.
Mm-hmm.
We're excited that you came and talked to us about it.
Thank you.
So we hope that you will get really involved with this. There's all kinds of ways you can get involved, but the first one is to spread the word, get some of the local artists that you know, or if you're a local artist, you get involved and contribute a piece of work to this piece. Now, you'll only own the winning piece. The rest of them, the artists will continue to own their own work.
That's right.
So it's not like you're donating a piece of work and then it just goes into Neverland. Only the winning piece, and then
mm-hmm.
for that, they get the prizes and the notoriety and so forth.
Right.
So we're excited about this. We hope you'll be excited about it. Thank you, Suzanne, for all you're doing and for coming and talking to us about this.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to be coming back and talking again later after we announce the winners
uh-huh.
and sharing this a little bit more, a little tidbit here and there about this festival with you. So we look forward to this, and we look forward to this Festival of the Book. Thank you, and stay in touch with us, and stay in touch with the Festival of the Book.
Watauga Arts Council with your host, Cherry Johnson, serving arts in Watauga County for more than 30 years.